So the killing of one man never destroys the values. It destroys that person. But the value system goes on. Racism, bigotry, stupidity are part of the problem. Stupidity means lack of information regarding certain types of problems. When you read in a book that revenge is sweet, and if that takes as a system, it hurts people. Therefore, all that type of literature has to go. To the extent that we raise our children with artificial values, that will produce harm in the future. You think, well, they're only children. I don't think it's that necessary. Well, war, guns, possession of guns are partly nurtured by our culture. And guns give people a sense of power. A false sense of power. Real sense of power is delivery of information that's relevant to people. Well, of course, you don't sense it right away. You don't feel a glorious feeling, do you? And all short-term investments, they appear to stay on, but they only perpetuate problems into the future. The major problem with the world's people today is they believe that human values and behavior and decisions are made within their human being. Actually, this is not the case. That's a major cause of most of the world. And it's the environment they're reared. You cannot understand that. Think of the language and the values you have. And the attitudes about a good old USA. If you grew up in Iran, the value system would be different. Your language would be different. Therefore, it is not within the human being to know the difference between what you would call operant behavior or useful behavior or useful values. All your values are inculcated by the environment, the books you read, the motion pictures you see, the role models you have. Therefore, human beings are not, I repeat this, are not responsible for their values. They are learned. If you don't understand that, you should become more familiar with the effects of environment on human behavior. The very fact that they used to burn witches in Salem, Massachusetts, might mean that within that area, most people were brought up with some of their values. The notions of heaven and hell come from books and other people. Your language comes from your environment. Possibly the difference between a Roman and a Greek could be the environment they're reared in. If you don't understand that, you need a lot of education, a lot of information. We have to seek information that's relevant to people, not information based on opinion, profile, hand-down value, or feelings of good and bad. All those feelings of good, bad, right, wrong are all learned. Everything. If you still don't understand that, look back at the word you use, and you'll find that they're words that are picked up in the reverse. An Englishman speaks with an English accent, not because he's English, because he's been exposed to that environment and those sounds and words. An Australian speaks like an Australian, because he's brought up in an environment that utilizes that dialogue. A northerner, southerner speaks differently than a northerner. And if you still don't understand that, that's the best I can do.